A woman attacked her own attorney. Put up the picture full mass. Quite interesting. 25-year-old Taylor Schabusiness, a Green Bay, Wisconsin woman, was on trial in the gruesome killing and dismemberment of Shad Thyrion. Attacked her own attorney in the courtroom after a judge agreed to delay the case, not give her a guilty, not give her a sentence, just delay the case. So she is charged with first degree intentional homicide, mutilating a corpse, and third degree sexual assault for allegedly attacking Shad Thyrion in February 2022. She has pleaded not guilty and not guilty by reason of mental disease or defect. Separate from the so-called insanity plea, also yet to be decided, is a defense claim that she is not competent to stand trial. Competency refers to the defendant's ability to understand the court proceedings and assist in their own defense. If deemed competent, the case would proceed. If deemed not competent, the case would be put on hold while she receives additional psychiatric treatment. According to the report, defense counsel Quinn Jolly said this new expert review is not yet complete and asked a judge, Judge Thomas Walsh, for a delay of 2 weeks to finish that assessment. The judge agreed. Immediately after this, according to the report, Schabusiness then attacked Jolly and was wrestled to the ground by a deputy. Jolly is now seeking a motion to withdraw as the attorney, although the judge has not ruled in that matter. The judge probably doesn't like the lawyer. Schabusiness and Thyrion both attended and dropped out of the same high school, according to Green Bay Press Gazette. Detectives believe the two met at Thyrion's house, took methamphetamine and the antidepressant trazodone, and then they had a sexual encounter. Schabusiness confessed to investigators that she choked him with a chain after this encounter, discovered he was dead, decapitated his corpse with a bread knife, then removed other limbs, taking some with her and leaving the head behind in a bucket covered with a towel. I know that is very hard to hear, very hard to say as well. A few issues here. Number one, there's a reality, a cause and effect relationship between what we know to be an epidemic in America, drug use, okay, drug abuse, and our avenues available for people to obtain help. Really a horrible system, to be honest. People who have engaged in illegal narcotics and sometimes legal drugs find it very difficult to actually obtain help. It's a mental health issue. Number two, the fact that she did cover it up is evidence of a guilty conscience. Typically, that will always land you in the competency arena. The idea of mental competency has very little to do with your actual mental health state. Many of us have variations of mental health, me included. The idea is, do you know what you did was wrong? Did you engage in behavior that became a catalyst to that wrong? For example, if you decided to drink a lot of alcohol and get inside of your car, you may not remember the accident, but you remembered getting drunk and it could have led to what happened, all right? So this is obviously going to be decided by a court. One of the absolute worst things out of this is that somebody's dead. Somebody's dead and they will be no more. Criminal justice system, in many ways, holistically incapable of actually solving problems, but creating punishment. And hopefully this punishment will be fitting and appropriate. All right, thoughts here.
So I actually have a few questions for you because I'm unsure of criminal justice proceedings. Like, how would her attacking the lawyer be perceived by, I don't know, additional lawyers or the prosecutors or, I don't know, the people who are going to looking at this case and deeming whether she's guilty or innocent?
You know, that's a great question. Number one, it cannot be introduced to her current trial or in her current trial because it would bias the jury. The issue at hand has nothing to do with her being or her attacking the attorney. That would likely be a separate case. Definitely would not be something introduced in the trial. As far as representation is concerned, you have to waive your right to representation. You have this fundamental right. Some judges have tried to say things like, well, if the individual acts in a way that's adversarial to the attorney, then they have de facto waived it. But higher courts have ruled, no, it doesn't work that way. You got to make other provisions. If they do not waive right to counsel, they will have right to counsel, period. It doesn't mean the counsel wants them to have that right for them because currently the attorney is saying, I need off this case now. That has not been determined. But I have seen scenarios, dear brother, where they literally will allow the defendant to remain in one part of either A, the courtroom or remain at the jail and they will watch the proceedings because they are dangerous or they cart them in a wheelchair, which I think is insane, and have them chained up. That does bias the jury in a significant way because the jury is well aware you are in these shackles in front of us because you've done something to scare your own legal team. All right.
All right. I was just, you know, in my mind, I'm like, if I was in a jury, I'd be like, oh, she just attacked a lawyer. She did that. So I'm glad I know. Thank you.
There you go.